So here today we will see a stable multivibrator using 555 timer. So this is a configuration of a stable multivibrator using 555 timer IC. So where we have two resistors and one capacitors, and this capacitor is connected with the trigger input, and seventh pin is a discharge pin. So in this stable multivibrator, we would not give any trigger input voltage. We will not give any voltage as like other multivibrators. So here, when the supply voltage is on, when VCC is on, before that, so inside there is a two comparators and one flip flop, and one transistor is present inside the 555 timer. So that we will not focus much. We will derive what is the output of this multivibrator. So using that, we will do some problems. So here, when the supply VCC biasing voltage is on, this capacitor is tries to charge using the resistors RA and RB. So that time the time constant tau is equal to RA plus RB into C. So the capacitor is charging. So that time the output voltage is the maximum. Maximum voltage. When the capacitor voltage reaches the maximum threshold voltage VTH, that time the output is brought to zero due to the internal working operation. So that time the capacitor tries to discharge through pin number seven. It tries to discharge. When it reaches lower threshold voltage, that is VTL, again the capacitor voltage, the output voltage becomes high. The capacitor tries to charge, again discharge. So charging is happened using the resistors RA, RBC, and the discharge is happened using the resistors RB. Through this resistor only it will discharge. So that alone we will consider, and using that we will derive the what is a time period, what is a pulse width and the frequency that we will derive. So here for any analog IC, the width of the pulse is equal to tau into ln V infinity minus VI. So infinity meaning that steady state, V naught is called initial state. This is a steady state, and VA is called final stage. So again, we will write the formula here. Infinity minus initial state, infinity minus final value. So first we will calculate TL. TL is the time period when the capacitor is discharged. So that time when it is allowed to discharge, the its steady state value is zero. That is when it is allowed to discharge, the steady state value is zero. So first one is V of infinity when it is allowed, the steady state value is zero. So when it with the initial stage of the discharge period is VTH. Then it is V infinity is zero. Then VI, it is a final stage. The final stage of the discharge period is VTL. So again, the VTL is chosen in such a way that it is exactly half of the VTH. So when we simplify this TL values, RB, C, LN2. This is a bit. Now in the same manner, we will calculate this TH. So TH is called a charging period. This charging period, the initial state is VTL, and the final stage is VTH, and the steady state is VCC. Steady state value is infinity, value is VCC. Initial state, that is formula is initial state is VTL, and a final state is VTH. Now substitute VTL equal to we get VTH by 2, that is half of maximum value. Then VTH is chosen 2/3 of supply voltage. So substituting these two values, we have TH TH is equal to Ra plus Rb C ln 2. So what is TH is the on period. TH is otherwise called on period and TL is otherwise called off period. So we got the answer. We derived TL and TH. So total time period is equal to on time plus off time. So we are combining two. So T is equal to this. So T frequency is equal to 1 over T. Ln 2 value is 1.44. So we got the answer as frequency. So we remember this formula. This formula is This formula will be useful for doing more problems. Again, duty cycle is on time. TH is on time divided by total time. So on time is TH and total time. Combine these two. We have the answer Ra Rb plus Ra plus 2 times Rb. So we will memorize four formula: TL, TH, frequency and duty cycle. Using this formula we will see the problems. The circuit shown in figure is a 555 timer IC connected as a stable multivibrator. The value of capacitor C is 10 nanofarad. The value of Ra and Rb for the frequency of 10 kilohertz and the duty cycle of 0.75 for the output voltage waveform R. So here they were asking to find what is the value of Ra and Rb, the operating frequency of the output voltage. The output voltage frequency is 10 kilohertz, the capacitor value is 10 microfarad. Now given values are capacitor is 10 microfarad, so 10 into 10 power minus 9 farad. The output voltage having the frequency of 10 kilohertz, so time is equal to 1 over frequency, that is equal to 0.1 millisecond. Also given as duty cycle is D is equal to 0.75. So just now we derived for a stable multivibrator, frequency is equal to 1.44 divided by Ra plus 2 times Rb into C. Just we derived. So substitute the respective values. The frequency is 10 into 10 power 3 and RC value is 10 nanofarad. So we got the answer. First equation is Ra plus 2 times Rb is equal to this value. Again we also derived the duty ratio. Duty cycle formula is Ra plus Rb over this. So given us the duty cycle is 0.75, so substitute the respective value Ra plus Rb. So using equation 1, Ra plus 2 times Rb is equal to 14,400. So the denominator is Ra plus 2 times Rb, that is 14,400. So we got the answer. We got to another equation called Ra is equal to 10,800 minus Rb. Substitute this 10,800 in equation 1. Instead of this Ra, you substitute and calculate Rb values 3600 or 3.6 kilo ohm. So therefore this Rb you substitute here. Again substitute Rb here, you will get Ra. Ra value is 7.2 kilo ohms. Find the charging and discharging time of the given circuit where capacitance value is given as 0.5 microfarad. So from the configuration we can conclude that it is a stable multivibrator, where we derived the formula for a TL, that is a discharge time, where we derived as RBC ln 2. This is for discharge time. So substitute the respective values. RB value is 10 power 3 5 kilo ohm and the capacitor is 0.5 microfarad, ln 2. So the answer is 1.73. this is a discharge time. And the charging time, that is denoted by TH, the formula is Ra Rb C ln 2. So substitute the respective value. So Ra value is 10 kilo and Rb value is 5 kilo. So substitute all the values and charging time is 5 millisecond. So discharge time is 1.73 and the charging time is 5.2. 2 milliseconds.